Hello guys, this is the second part of the video Principles and Techniques of Scientific Management. First part of this video contains principles of scientific management and this part contains techniques of scientific management. So if you want to see principles, kindly click the link below, and if you want to watch techniques of scientific management, then stick to this video. So here are five main techniques of scientific management, which are functional foremanship, standardization of work, scientific study of work, and differential wage system, which is also known as differential piece rate, and mental revolution. Let's understand each of these one by one. First is functional foremanship. It is an extension of principle of division of labor, resulting in specialization. According to Taylor, a single worker or supervisor cannot be expected to be an expert in all aspects. Thus, he advocated the appointment of 8 foremen to guide workers under planning and production department. Under the planning in charge, there are 4 personnel, which are instruction card clerk, route clerk, time and cost clerk, and disciplinarian. Whereas under the production in charge, there are also 4 personnel, which are gang boss, repair boss, inspector, and speed boss. Let's do a very brief introduction of all of these personnel. First is instruction card clerk. This clerk prepares the instruction cards for the workers and hands them over to the gang boss. These cards contain information about the nature of the work, procedure of doing it, material to be used, and details about machinery, etc. Next is route clerk. This clerk ensures the sequence of completing a particular work and also decides the job to be done for the day and where it is to be done. Okay. And third is time and cost clerk. This clerk decides as to when a particular work is to be started and finished, and also decides at what cost the product will be produced. Next is disciplinarian. He ensures that every work is being performed in a disciplinarian manner. Okay. So, in production in charge, first is gang boss. See, the workers are divided into various groups from the point of view of control, and a group leader is selected who is known as the gang boss. He is expected to ensure that both the workers and the machines are fit enough for production and that the material required for their use has been made available to them. Okay. Next is repair boss. The main function of the repair boss is to keep the machines and tools in working condition. Third is inspector. He inspects the things and produces and compares their quality with the standard prescribed for them and tries to find out the difference. In case of unfavorable result, he initiates corrective actions. Okay. And the last one is speed boss. The main function of the speed boss is to ensure that all the workers are performing their job at the required or expected speed so that work can be completed at the required time. Next technique of scientific management is standardization of work. Standardization means setting standard for different factors after due deliberation or after due consideration. For example, the amount of work to be done by a worker in a day may be standardized. In other words, the worker is expected to do the standard amount of work every day. In the same manner, standard may also be set for raw material, techniques, machine and tools, condition of work, etc. Third technique is scientific study of work. It means to conduct the deep analysis of all the activities being performed in the organization with the aim of producing maximum possible quality output at minimum cost. Taylor has conducted the following studies: method study, motion study, time study, and fatigue study. Let's know about each of these studies one by one. First is method study. This technique of scientific management is conducted to find out the one best method or way of performing a particular task. The objective of this study is to minimize the cost of production and maximize the quality and satisfaction of the consumer. Next is motion study. Motion study refers to an in-depth study of movement of a worker while doing a task. Taylor recognized 3 types of movement: productive, unproductive, and incidental. The objective of motion study is to eliminate unproductive movement in doing a task to achieve efficiency and reduce the time required to do the task. Third is time study. It determines the standard time taken to perform a well-defined job. Time-measuring devices were used to conduct this study. This type of study is helpful in deciding the time required to perform a job. And fourth is fatigue study. Fatigue study seeks to find out the amount and frequency of rest intervals to be given to worker in completing a task. This would help the worker to regain his stamina and work with the same efficiency again. It also aims to reduce various causes of fatigue, such as long working hours, doing unsuitable work, bad working conditions, etc. Fourth technique of scientific management is differential wage system or differential piece rate. Taylor has advised the adoption of differential wage system in order to motivate the employees. According to this system, wages are paid on the basis of work done and not on the basis of time spent in doing the work. That means wages are directly proportional to work done. In this system, two different wage rates are used. One is a high wage rate and the other is a low wage rate. Those workers who are able to produce the standard amount of unit within a fixed duration are paid as per the high wage rate, and those workers who are not able to produce the standard amount of unit within the same time are paid as the lower wage rate. As a result, less efficient workers will be motivated to work more and efficient workers will be motivated to maintain their efficiency. Now the last and fifth technique is mental revolution. Mental revolution calls for a change in the mindset of both employees and workers. As per Taylor, a revolution in mindset of both the employees and the worker is required because it will promote feeling of cooperation and will be beneficial to both the parties. Normally, it is seen that conflict between employers and workers result in division of profit, with both the parties demanding a larger share of profit. This is the main reason why a mental revolution is required. According to Taylor, instead of fighting over division of profit, both the parties should make efforts for increasing the profits. That's all. Hope you like this video. Please do not forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you.